and everyone making a walk with my son. That is, oh, it's awesome weather today. There's a little bit of light and we are looking for a tawny owl. There's a tawny owl here in the neighborhood. I haven't been here for a while, so I have no idea if we can find him. My son is more clever than me. Must have my wife's genes. He's still there. It's so amazing, but it's besides the path, there's an old beech tree. Oh, he's sitting. It's like he's looking out over everyone who comes over here, over this path. Let's see if we can make a few photos. Tawny owl sitting in a beech tree. That's the photo that you can make of this beautiful bird. I'm really happy with this photo, because it was a while ago I last found a tawny owl. But something was bothering me about this photo. There's just one thing. That's always the thing if you're photographing upwards, is that the background, the sky is very, very bright, and that's something that I do not like. But a little bit further away into the woods, there's an old Douglas fir. And I think if I'm going to stand a little bit further away, I can get that Douglas fir in the background. So I might be able to eliminate that bright background. Both to the left and to the right, I have this dark Douglas fir, so it took a bit moving around, going from left to right, trying to make as much use of the Douglas fir to make the background dark. Finally, I was able to make a photo. In this photo, the owl is much more the star of the show. So often it's about contrast in photography, right? Oh! Late for that. He was scratching his ear. His eyes are closed again. Oh, what I was about. Photos are about contrast, right? You want to have contrast between your subject and the rest of the photo. If it's all the same color or the same brightness, or then you do not have a subject where people are looking at. So if you have this bright white sky in the background and the subject itself is dark, that's not really the contrast that you're looking for, because your eyes are drawn to those white spots. So being able to eliminate those white spots, that's great. That gives a better photo. If it wasn't for the wintry conditions a week later, this would have been the end of the vlog. I suddenly realized something. If the owl was using this roosting site, the wind would be blowing from the side of his face. His head would be covered on only one side with snow then. So I decided to go out. Carefully I drove the 30 kilometers to this site, hoping it wouldn't be for nothing. owl was sitting right where I hoped it would be.
Oh, so cool. Oh, that'd be snowing the whole day. Finally snowing. Oh, and the whole day on the radio, it was warned, do not go on the street because there are a lot of accidents. But luckily, this tawny owl was not that far away, so... Oh, and the light was fading really fast. It's really dark now. It's too dark to make photos.
It took me until the end of the day to realize I could not let this opportunity slip away. If I would go the next day, the face of the owl wouldn't be covered in snow. When I arrived with the last usable light, I took a few photos, hoping they would work out.
If you stay home, you're not making anything, right? Oh.
I am so happy with this photo. It tells such a great story of this owl surviving these wintry conditions, and it is proof that sometimes you need to put in more effort than other photos. It is amazing to see how the feathers of this owl is insulating the bird. There is no heat escaping his body, melting the snow. I really hope you liked this vlog. If you did, a like and a comment would be much appreciated. If you aren't subscribed yet, do not forget to do so. And do hit that notification bell. And then we will see each other again in my next vlog.